The Bakersfield Police Department has identified the man who died in a hit and run last night on Brundage. He is 66-year-old Arthur Lee Hayes.
Eyewitness News reporter Adam Herbetz joins us now after speaking to his family. Adam.
Kendall, Courtney, it had already been a hard chapter for Hayes and his family. His wife had just passed away a few months ago, and now his kids are both without parents. Now it's even harder, knowing that the person that did this to their father is still on the road.
Just not real. It just don't seem real. That was the last parent we had.
Jamila Hayes and the family she has left were up all day and night on Monday looking for their father.
We knew something had to be wrong.
But as they searched, they had no idea his body was left for dead on Brundage Lane near U Street, half a dozen miles away from home.
I still don't want to believe it. A person that does that has no heart.
66-year-old Arthur Hayes had dementia, and his kids say he was just starting to get his life back on track after losing his wife.
We even quit our jobs to take care of him. Our mom just passed away 4 months ago.
Hayes was outside of the crosswalk, meaning if the driver stopped and wasn't under the influence,
he would not be at fault.
To make it even more difficult, gruesome pictures of the scene started showing up all over social media. We won't show the images, but one viewer posted on our Facebook page, quote, "I just saw pictures related to this news. So disturbing, and no respect for the man who was hit." The Bakersfield Police Department wants that to stop.
I think, honestly, it's quite tasteless to do that for somebody who's been killed in a traffic collision.
Investigators have a suspect description: dark-colored GMC or Chevy pickup truck with an extended cab and damage to the front of the car. They're also working on getting surveillance footage. They just hope it doesn't have to come down to that. The family just hopes for closure.
Come forward and tell us your side of the story. That's all we want. We want peace.
Yeah, absolutely. We urge that person to turn themselves in, to give us their side of the story. Tell us what happened.
March 16th would have been the Hayes anniversary. Now it's another hump to get over, part of another tough grieving process.
I wish I could see them, but they're together now. They're happy.
Jamila says her father was a very, very sweet man that would give the shirt off of his back to anybody in need. BPD was also able to get a partial license plate number. That number should be at the bottom of your screen, and anyone with information, please call the police department. Reporting in studio, Adam Herbetz, Eyewitness News. Courtney.